Hey, what's up, dudes? Kubla Khan here, and welcome back to Fallout 4 Survival Roleplay with our Sugar Bomb Agility build. Welcome, and welcome to meeting Vilificent. I am shortening her name to V, because at times it is difficult to say Vilificent. However, that is who our character is, and she is currently stuck on a roof. Now, this happened because, as you can see, the crashed vertebird, that was what she was on. She came from the Brotherhood of Steel, but why an address? Well, she was raised in the Brotherhood of Steel, and it was something that she rejected. She didn't like how strict they were, how much honor and glory they would talk about, when reality was all about how to control your life and force you to do things you didn't want to do. And when she was taken out on the Brotherhood of Steel little vertebird fly around, her father, who was piloting it, took her out and said, come on, let's talk. And she was like, you know what? I'm going to wear whatever I want. I don't even want to wear stupid armor. Puts on a dress, probably the worst thing to wear out in the Commonwealth right now, and well, they were shot down and they crashed. She bailed right here and landed on the roof. Now, there's gonna be a little bit more to the story. It's for one, her hate of all forms of not community, her dress every time I jump off of this. I've done this a couple times and her dress always pops up. And it's not her hate of community, it's her hate of authority, of that, you know, fascist style of this is how the military works. She doesn't like the militarization. And she absolutely hates how people are being forced to do things. How the Brotherhood's like, we know what's good for you, and you're just gonna do it. And in that same light, the Institute, who the Brotherhood hates, she has also grown to hate because of the same behavior. True, they have different opinions on how they're supposed to affect the normal world, but it's something that for her, she's like, it doesn't matter who you are, stop taking control. Now, at the moment, she's completely and utterly unarmed. I mean, there is nothing on her that I'm going to be able to use. So I know that we are near some bugs. And so I'm going to do my best to get into this house and save, because this is the very beginning of our survival. And our character isn't exactly the smartest survival build. Let's get this open, get this closed, grab this baseball bat real quick, because that's just going to be helpful. Now, we do have a pit boy, and we're not from the vault, but you know what? It's sometimes we can't control that, so we're just gonna deal with it. All right, let's drop that first save. Boom. And we have the first save, Jet Mentats, perfect. Now, she's currently at level 2, and let me give you a little walkthrough about who her character is. We are going to be taking commando, probably pretty early on. In response, we're probably gonna take something like scrounger, because we're gonna have a lot of ammunition that we need to carry. And for that same reason, lone wanderer, with increasing the carry weight, demolition is something else we'll be choosing and picking up soon, because her explosives are a way of doing it. Also, something like moving targets can be very important for us to be able to run into battles, because being that survival, we take a lot more damage than normal, and we're going to be playing a pretty bad, this isn't supposed to be in here, a pretty bad situation if we're not smart about how we enter and exit our fights. Ooh, hello Nuka Cola Quantum, and sugar bombs! What a perfect thing for our build to find so early on. Now we got our baseball bat. She doesn't use baseball bats, she uses automatic weapons, but we're gonna start with this so that we can get ourselves into Concord and begin to pick up some weapons and items and start that first Concord mission. All right, so one of the things that as my like first set goal, this character is gonna head over to Far Harbor to blow up the Children of Adam. Because one thing you don't like about structure is religions have a lot of structure, and the Children of Adam and Far Harbor absolutely have that. Guess we'll take a switchblade and some of these. Eyeglasses, let's get that on. Harness for a little bit of something. Raider left leg. Sack hood with straps. Nah, that's really pointless. We have these wedding rings here. Don't need them. All right, there's our first target. We're gonna play a little baseball with their face. Da-da.
What the hell was that?
Da-da.
Payback time, boogeyman.
I don't know why you're saying, oh God, that's our brain. Oh, our brain's hurting. Our brain is hurting. Oh no, I can't see. Block it! Okay. Oh man, this is dangerous. Well, death counter one. So other things related to the character in general, I could imagine her going off to blowing up the Children of Adam. I could also see her doing something along the lines of, oh look, I didn't realize we had the glasses to start with. Let's drop those. I think that also goes along potentially of doing something like the railroad, because as much as we are, as our character, the railroad kind of just stands for anti-establishment. That, and so does the Minutemen in a way. I mean, they don't really have an authority in the Minutemen. They have the general, But that's really kind of a thing. If you've ever played with alongside the Minutemen and try to get them to do things, you have to convince them that it's the right thing. No authority really exists. So, and this is kind of going to be the groundwork of our character, because we want her to eventually basically lead a bunch of raiders to destroy the Commonwealth. Now, so she's not good, right? She's kind of neutral, chaotic neutral, but she can do good things, basically that'll fit within the lore of why she's going to help these individuals here fighting the raiders. She also will hate things like Diamond City, because, you know, it's like Diamond City just has their stupid rules and laws about how they do everything. And she'll, like, tolerate them, but it's good neighbor that she really will connect to. And it'll be good neighbor that we'll try to put a house in if we're gonna ever get a house. What, pal? Our first raider. Hello! Long johns. Raider right leg. We don't want that sack hood. You know, their long johns look pretty interesting. Now, why isn't, the reason why Preston Garvey isn't shooting at them right now is because it's actually, I've had the character start a little bit later into, I guess, the start of everything? Like, she's been on the roof for some time as I was doing some other filming. Now, an important thing about our character, which is a bit of a problematic situation, is that when you're playing these characters, you want to play somebody who is able to respond to problems, and typically that's something that these roleplay builds kind of avoid. We want the person to respond, but only within a certain limited view. More importantly to that certain limited view, hey, he's gonna shout at us in a second.
Hey, up here, on the balcony, please!
There it is. Okay, so I picked up all the stuff off the dead people. Now, you notice the scars or the stitches on her face? Those are examples of her acting out against what she's been told to do, and you're not supposed to have things like that in military environments and the like. So she's just being herself and expressing herself. So she's going to go after any forms of authority. She doesn't like them. That she's going to be sarcastic. She helps because she wants to, not because she was told to. She does things for only as she wants to do. Now, we just got overweight, and I think immediately I'm going to take Lone Wanderer. Because if you look here, we have a very, very low strength. So I'm going to be making sure that we eventually get armor, because I want to get ballistic weave and the like from the railroad. And that's going to fit really well with our character because she is, a light weapons user. You know, I'll take agility perception up. All right, now we got ourselves Minutemen, Undercoat, and then a bunch of other raider pieces of armor and stuff so that she has some form of covering to be able to fight. Now, as we enter here, there's something very important that I want to bring up about how one typically plays in a survival mode. And that is careful. Typically, one will be careful in survival mode. Typically, one will sneak because the high extra damage on opponents is great for surprising them. And the high extra damage on yourself means you don't want to be seen. Our character, at least in the early levels, is probably going to be incredibly squishy. And it's going to be very tough, and we're going to probably have to do a little bit more sneaking and stuff than what we would really want the character to do. But I'm not going to put anything necessarily in the sneak perks because I don't really want that. I kind of want to have somebody who's going to be quick on her feet, jumping back and forth. So a lot of that damage resistance jumping to different things. Remember, any Molotov cocktail, though, will absolutely demolish us. All right, perfect. Level 3 up. Man, we level up really fast in survival mode. That was one whole level. Oh, no, we got an experience boost, too, from the mission. That's right. I say commando. Let's rock that. Boom. Go, go, go. Jump. Jump. Run, 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 run. So I did this a couple times experimenting, and I mentioned about how I played a character that took the place of Fizzy accidentally, and then we had that problem with him. Well, this is the character that I was, experimenting a little bit with, and I had a completely different save and the like, and I discovered that you die a lot in this room, which is in fact something that I did. So it's, that's why I'm being a little bit more careful every time I'm jumping around these corners. You don't see me necessarily just bolting through wildly, which is what I tried the first time and was not good. One thing of note, when we're worried about ammunition and stuff, notice how I'm at 12 and 83. With this incredibly light,
I'm telling you, man, let's just get the hell out of here.
Very small caliber weapon, we actually do very well in collecting ammunition quickly. Remember, another part of our character was explosive, so we're gonna grab a Molotov cocktail.
We hold out for the others, like we're supposed to.
What are you, deaf? Somebody's out there shooting the place up.
Problem solved, eh? I had a lot of problems fighting up against that group of people the first couple times I went in here. It's just, you would shoot at one, and you'd be able to kill that one pretty quickly. But the other one was quick on their feet, and that was the problem. They would just, you'd get one, and then the other one would be in your face, and it would be a much closer combat than I needed it to be. Now, for those of you who know what's coming up, that gun that I'm about to be using in a little bit actually doesn't work with commando. Even though it's a very automatic weapon, you're just dead, and you're just dead. Whoop! No, you're not just dead. Boo-boo! Uh-oh. Close the door. Perfect. All right, too much to run. That's A-okay. We'll have our first little bit of dropping stuff because we've just been picking up all the pipe weaponry to get as much ammunition as possible. Also, baseball bat, we can throw that out. You know, one thing that might be worth keeping is some of these items, especially, see that bayonet there? We might find that our character actually does really well with Basher. Because we will want to have a lot of extra strength for when we're carrying so much extra ammunition. Something like Basher could be pretty damn cool. I mean, arguably, we could just get to strong back, and that will make more sense in order to just keep building that up. I mean, but I don't really... One, and then two, maybe? I don't really know exactly how far we're going to go with it. But anyway, something like Basher, when I was running around, I found that it was actually kind of useful because it would often do an instant kill. Also, it'd be fun to hold on to some of these pipe things because it's like glow-sided might be really cool on some of our honor weapons. And these weapons we'll probably use a lot of because the ammunition's easy to find. Actually, you know what? I just dropped all these pipe ones. These pipe ones are, in fact, kind of valuable. It's things like the musket we don't really want. The revolver we don't really want. The short pipe rifle, eh. There we go. Dropped a bunch of worthless armors. Yes. The little fairy ring of dead people's things. Alright, so, we've done a lot of this conversation before, so I'm gonna just hop through this very quickly for you.
Perfect.
First, we want to get this, though. Whew! Always useful. Oh, just as a heads up, I did in fact get the special book in the room back in Sanctuary, even though our character started out here.
Minigun.
Alright, there we go. So remember, our character did not come from the vault. Now, our character will not be above lying that she came from a vault. And I think that'll be useful because there are a couple parts of the game that will be nice to be able to be like, hey, we're looking for our son, kind of thing. And that would actually be kind of an interesting character choice because the reason why we're doing that is to get people's sympathy and taking advantage of them. And so with our focus on commando as well, we actually have a couple other advantages that, you know, because typically you can't really sneak as easily with commando. You can, in fact, silence some commando weapons. But without the, you know, like that single initial hit, it's just, I don't know how each bullet is calculated with the commando weapon. And then when you're using critical hits and the like, it's just, it's definitely a little different and I'm not 100% sure how it's going to go. But we are certainly not going to be sniping, really. So it means that we're going to be getting up into people's faces, which, like I mentioned, puts us into harm's way, which is a dangerous situation to be in for anyone in survival mode, but especially ourselves who, well, we're not building ourselves to be a heavy armor character. Maybe we'll use some power armor because she has been taught how to use it in the Brotherhood of Steel. But it's definitely not something that, you know, will be a for sure. We are in a position, though, where with a character who's going to go to the Children of Atom and potentially do the Railroad, because in the Railroad there's some big explosions that you get to do, that would be end game. We would actually be doing an end game run. Which would be kind of crazy because we've never done one of those on this channel. An end game run with a character designed around the idea of turning evil to take out and sack the Commonwealth. So possibly, maybe she would have potentially become good, but because of the way we're going to do it, it's going to turn into a lot of mini explosions and killing.
Show me that fancy gun up.
Hello? Oh, yes. Oh, this part of the game is always such a fun part. I mean, especially in survival mode, like, you're definitely not as powerful as you are in the normal mode at this point. Let's eat some sugar bombs. But damn, is it just fun. You know, like, especially we tear through people so much faster in this case. And the armor feels like it actually does a lot more. Bam. I'm just gonna walk up here and shoot this guy a bunch. So yeah, this gun does not work off a commando, interestingly. You know, there's obvious signs of why it should possibly work off commando. And that's the sound of the death claw out there, if any of you are interested and don't actually know. Fire at the legs if you're fighting the Deathclaw. Back up, though, because he can hit through that right there. He cannot use stairs, however, so we're actually pretty safe back here. And just hiding upside. Always shoot him. Oh, my God. Oh, he's coming down. Oh, God. Oh, wow. That was wicked. Oh, wow. It's a Molotov's crazy high damage, remember? Are you shooting at me? What an idiot. All right, it looks like we actually weakened its foot. Yeah, okay. It's done. It's the Deathclaw, basically not a worry anymore. Oh, come on, bro. Don't walk away like that. Hey, dude, I'm sorry for shooting you in the leg. Yeah, throw some dirt on me. See, this is why I love taking advantage of some of these survival mode things, because you can shoot people in the leg, and these just gonna, you know, slowly get closer. Keep throwing dust. But I'm just gonna go for his head. Oh, backing off again. Uh-oh. Let me just turn around from the, you know, and fight the more threatening thing. This little dude with the little pew-pew-pew. Oh, buddy, I'm sorry. Let's see if we can save some of this ammunition, though, to sell. I'm aiming for the, for try to get headshots here. All right. Just keep backing up. Whew. Now, see, this definitely makes it look like I knew what I was doing when I was playing before. Trust me, this was surprisingly hard the first couple times I was trying it. Alright, Raider. Now, you always want to go to Gristle because he has the Corvega storage key. Which is some pretty cool stuff in it when you actually get to Corvega Plant, which we're going to because we always go to Corvega Plant in one of our playthroughs. It's just almost like a tradition. I'm throwing the minigun down because we're not really going to ever use that ever again. The armor, on the other hand, we might actually find a use for this still. There we go, we got ourselves a new welded Raider chest piece as well. God, we look positively frightening, which is exactly what I think she would want. So as we talk to these lovely people, step one for our character is going to go as quickly as possible to blow up the Children of Adam. Because why not? I think that'll just be a fun sort of direct thing for us to go towards. And during the process, if we bump into the railroad, we'll help them out and screwing with the Brotherhood of Steel and screwing with the Institute. Now, if that kind of begins to lead us down the main story route, let's chat about it. Let's see if that's actually what we're going to do. But the thing is, there are some pretty damn cool options for our character to blow shit up.
I'm on my own side, Garvey.
Yeah, sarcasm.
Shame. You can never have too many friends in the Commonwealth.
Sure. You're trying to play me for a fool.
Aw, no, kid, no. The sights.
Ugh.
And even I don't need the sight to tell you where.
Oh my God. I just
looking.
Said, like, you're bullshitting me because I'm practicing being evil. If you press B again, she says, old people. That was awesome. Very proud of that. That was hilarious. All right, next step is Sanctuary, where we're going to be able to pop a fusion core in here, move all our stuff, and we'll kind of prep for the next bit of the trip. So I've been told if you walk with these guys, there's actually some cool conversation that they have. I'll stroll with them for now to see if anything pops up, and then I'll pop in if I think it's anything that's worth showing. Because holy crap, do they take forever. Sorry.
First time I've seen one of these things up close. I'm very glad it's already dead.
I had to kill it. It was scary.
I can't believe we're going to Sanctuary just because Mama Murphy had a vision.
Now, one thing that I think is kind of entertaining about this character I forgot to mention is that she's kind of like April Ludgate from Parks and Recreation. If April Ludgate was, like, actually crazy rather than just, like, pretending to be. I mean, when we think about April Ludgate, she loves animals, right? That was, like, her thing. Well, that's kind of this character, too. She's way more into animals than she is into people.
Can't say I'm gonna miss this festering boil on the ass end of the Commonwealth. No offense if you're from here or something.
This is actually gonna help because these guys are surprisingly tough at these low levels. So having other people to take the damage for me is nice.
Better not be walking into another trap.
Why is there a plunger in the Brahmin? You know, I'm kind of curious to see what kind of conversation is going to happen when we get to the Red Rocket, because that's where we have Dogmeat hanging out. And we're going to take Dogmeat with us, I think at least for a little while. Not 100% sure, though.
Well, look at that. I think I just found my new vacation home.
Your idea of heaven, Ace Sturgis. Could be some good salvage in there. Let's get to Sanctuary first, though. I think we're close.
Hold on to that power armor now. Hate to see it go to rust.
What, they just ignore the dog? Hey! Come on, dog.
Hey, boy. Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Alright, so the thing is, with survival mode, you have to, like, give your dog stim packs if you can't get to it in time. So that's just something that I want to keep in mind when we're trying to play, because it's going to be probably kind of tough to keep, you know, a partner that's the dog, because the dog is all melee, right? So he's going to get hurt all the time, and he might just eat up my stim packs.
Well, I'll be damned. It's the monument to the original Minutemen. I knew that was somewhere around Concord. That means this right here must be the old North Bridge, where the first shots of the American Revolution were fired. I'd call that the best omen I've seen since we left Quincy.
Yeah, I don't know what you're talking about, boss, but I'm glad you decided to come with us.
I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us.
Well, people, I'm glad that you're finding your ways here. I'm not really going to be using Sanctuary for a lot of its settlement stuff. Preston providing us some more work immediately. I just walked him over here, and all of a sudden...
Trouble is.
Yeah.
I'd be glad to help.
Oh, I missed the sarcastic option. Damn it, I'm not experienced at being sarcastic. I'm used to just jamming A and ignoring him. We're doing okay in ammunition so far, especially if we keep using 38s. So I'm thinking maybe we should just take a gun nut and start making our guns extra powerful. Yeah, let's do it. Alright, the first thing to decide is, are we going to use a pistol or are we going to use a rifle? Well, the first thing is, if we're going to turn this into an automatic receiver, this is, does 12 damage. Turns out we can actually get a hardened automatic receiver at 16 damage. So they both do 16 damage. It's just probably a difference of accuracy over long distance. 71, 46, 179, 68. So yeah, that's exactly the situation. It just is a difference of how far you're actually able to shoot and the accuracy to it. Now, the thing is we're going to use a lot of our very important gear, screws, oil, adhesive. It might make sense to not do any changes to that and just stick with the pistol because this is already automatic. Put a drum mag on this. I realize I made a mistake. We have to do a hardened automatic receiver anyway, or we don't have to, but we might as well take advantage of that anyway. And I'm realizing, I was like, oh, wait a second, that's... didn't actually need, it could have been a rifle all the same. Oh well, let's make the change. All right, there we go. We have the good enough. That's basically what we're gonna start with. It's not exactly very shiny. It's not gonna help particularly, but sarcasm. Sarcasm to June Long.
I just wanna trade a few
things. Oh wait, it doesn't let me do it. I have to trade? Fine. Sarcastic.
I love work. I could sit and watch it all day.
Boom.
Well, for starters, we could use some real beds. We've been sleeping on the ground.
Sarcasm.
Do I look like a carpenter to you?
I don't know what Jesus. You look like. You said you were willing to help. Making beds is what we need help with.
Yes.
I'd be glad to help.
Okay. Good deal.
All right, a lot of these missions are a great way to start off when you're running around in Sanctuary. Now, not even like, as in like, oh, you need the experience or like education process. But actually because it gets you to start putting things into your workbench. Having stuff in your workbench is a very valuable beginning process. It's as you look around, I thought I had water, for example, and turned out I didn't put any water anywhere. Now, you can use dev codes to kind of load your character up with stuff and get them to a certain level that you need. But the actual workbench part is, you have to like know what you need to put in there and stuff. And doing something like this kind of, I feel like, really helps you have a better understanding of what's needed and what you're able to do. At one point, they're gonna want some water, so bang. Look at this guy, providing me work and then just taking a seat. What a nice man. You know, I think as quickly as possible, this character is, since we're gonna be focusing on actually doing some weapon crafting and the like, we're gonna be doing some farming, specifically adhesive farms. Mutt fruit, corn, that kind of thing. Now, we're not going to necessarily be doing it out here because this is a pretty poorly located settlement for us, but I think it could be something like Hangman's Alley or Overland Station. There are actually a lot of good options that could be centrally located and which will be much more useful for a character who's running around in survival mode. But also because we're going to be crossing into Far Harbor at one point, you know, and especially where our main head direction that we're going to be going, we'll be just straight over to there. I don't really know how much we need to necessarily set some of this up, because I feel like we'll just start finding stuff along the way. There we go. Drop our first save.
I like it. Having a place to sleep will improve everyone's spirits.
And their sleep. Apparently they want two pumps. This seems a little over the top, but, you know, whatever. Anything to get that sweet, sweet experience, right? They're using up valuable gears, though, but hey, there you go.
Good stuff.
So I just really quickly invited Codsworth to join me so I could get an experience boost with him. But the problem is that
Codsworth.
Immediately I lost the bonus of being in
you can head home now.
The Lone Wanderer. So that was a problem. Now I couldn't keep after our stupid dog because he was just walking away too fast. Alright, so now that we have a save dropped and we have our character fed and hydrated, we can start moving our way to kind of around the world. Now, the first main thing I'm going to go is hit up the Abernathy farm people over this side, because that'll allow us to get a couple items that will basically be able to bring back to Sanctuary, plant some food, get that mission done, then move back over to talk to the settlers at Ten Pines, who are going to send us down to Corvega Plant, which will then allow us to start moving our way to Diamond City. Now, our character, once again, is interested in causing explosions and the like, and as quickly as possible wants to get to Far Harbor, and so it may seem a little bit out of character for what we're doing right now, is just kind of starting the world and getting a set base for us. The thing is, our character likes shooting stuff and blowing stuff up, and this is going to allow us to shoot the most and blow the most stuff up. And here's the thing I really like, it let us just harvest all their tatoes. Like, I don't, once again, it's supposed to be like, they'll pay me to pick up their tatoes, but really, I'm just going to take it back to Sanctuary and plant them all there. Dog!
Hey.
This is the first time I've ever actually been able to use this. This is the dog. 28 tatoes, boy. Now, another thing about our character that is new, we can steal. Why not? We don't give a shit about anything. We're not like, oh, it's bad to steal. We take what we want to, and we do it because we need to. And that's another new thing for our character. Since now we're going to be all careful with stuff, why not just steal what we need? Which also, as I think about it, that means that potentially we can pretty much get everything that we actually need for, like, building stuff up just by taking it from people. Oh, man, stealing is nice. I feel a little bad, though. It's, which is new for me, because we always played as the ghoul who, like, had tough choices, but now we're actually gonna be evil. And my inclination's always to be nice, so it takes me a little bit of time before I feel comfortable, you know, stealing from people. So I keep... There you are. I couldn't figure out where any of these guys were. I think I have a face of trust, don't you? Like, it's good to see a new face. Very trustworthy. Alright, there we go. We got the returning the locket mission up. So if we end up doing it, we've got some experience that we can get. These delicious melons, which are very good because they give you both food and water for doing this. Dog, I got some more food for you to carry. This is like the equivalent of putting food on your dog's nose and just being like, Stay, and then I mean, go, and then he gets to eat it. Except that now he has to carry it for miles and miles. Now remember, if you're early on in the game, there is in fact a save right in this little shed spot. This is a good spot because it's just kind of quiet. No real problems in here. Alright, now I think it'll be a good idea to run off and do something that I've always found to be very useful, which this is the truck shipping area. This is the one where you have the robot, which remember, we don't like robots. Robots suck. But the thing is I'm fine with using robot and then blowing the hell out of it because it's going to run around and fight for us to keep us alive. And so she's going to be A-okay with the idea, perfect first try, of getting it to work for us and then taking advantage of it, but just after the fact, blowing it the hell up. Hey dog, let's go find some dead humans to shoot. Oh, you're just a normal dead human? There you are. Feral ghouls are scary again. But our dog has eaten his leg. Oh, that's right, we can stab with our cool weapon. Our weapon gun. Huh. Oh man, I forgot how fast level ups occur at these lower levels. Good fun. We might start doing awareness, but honestly, we're not gonna be using laser weapons for a while because we're not gonna do anything with the Brotherhood of Steel at all. Let's pop up demolition. Let's make those explosions even more powerful. Oh, there's a feral ghoul. Hey. Hey. Ah, too fast. Man, I love having this drum. Takes a long time to actually, that load is pretty slow. Did our dog jump down to attack that? You a good boy. Good boy. Go jump and put yourself in danger. Oh, man, there's music in the background. Just rocking to that. Feeling good. Hup. Let him fight. And we're at a small enough level that everybody's just like ferals and stuff. No problem. I'll take that baseball. Ooh, we just picked up some antibiotics. Oh man, so much of the ghoul's life was focused on that. Just another thing I'm a little worried about in relation to starting this build. We will, for the first time, be really dealing with radiation. That's gonna be new. It's definitely gonna be new. Alright, was that all the big scary dudes that we typically have to fight? I guess they are typically a lot bigger and scarier when you are a higher level. Because at this level, this is nothing. I mean, look, we only have one bobby pin remaining. That's what kind of level this is. And we didn't break it. You know, I feel like this character would also work well as a character who does pickpocketing. We've just never had a character who does that before. It could be just fun to put explosives in people's pants. That just seems like something our character would do. Alright, now for the bee's knees of why we're here. Let's grab the good stuff. Yes. Wicked shipping and Grognak the Barbarian. Unarmed and melee attacks, which we're not really going to be using. But for now, definitely good and useful anyway. So our character is all about springs, oil, steel, aluminum. You know, these are actually not very useful for oil-wise, so I'm not going to really be doing that. Ooh, armor workbench. We might be able to, oh, yes, we are. Yes, we are. Bring it up to tempered. Why not? Ultralight. Do it. One of our builds is also going to be armor, and I think that's going to be really useful too, because, like I mentioned, that it will work wonderfully with the ballistic weave. You're tired from lack of sleep? Gah. I'm fine. Don't be like that. Oh man, it's definitely a little tough for me to be like mean to people. I've been practicing with some of these characters where just a little bit off camera. This sarcasm. And like sometimes sarcasm is funny and cool. But it's this weird level for me where it's like, I want to be either complete evil or like, so it's like I shoot and kill everybody on sight. I can't like get to know them. Like that it's just too much. Wow, there's a lot of good stuff in there. Now we're going to be able to use this all the time when we need it. Oop, radiation. Alright, hold on, we're going to do it. Ah, okay, move. Actually, it's really not that bad back here. Dog! Oh, you're knocking over all this stuff. Run through. Alright. Hardlini rads, still doing okay. I do believe there's some radiation. There's some raiders who live in here. And I think I actually killed them once and used their arms as an art piece. Yep, I didn't, but it does feel familiar. Oh, cool. And a whiskey, I'll take that. Rad roach meats. Beer bottles, yeah, why not? Some more places to put water. And a quick save drop.
Wait there.
I like how I can tell the dog to stay because I am limping quietly over. Like, stay there, I'm really overweight. Don't move, damn it. Dog, hold on to this fusion core. Oh, dog can't care anymore. Oh. Alrighty then, let's take back our melons and our fruit. We've had the good little Corvega experience. Hello, we should sell to you. Put on our best prices dress. Oh, little bugs. Let me come by. Don't make me sick. Please don't make me sick. That's the biggest worry that these guys are now, is just sickness. God. Early level gameplay, you know? Getting yourself back up to that high power. You know one thing that'll be nice about getting back to Far Harbor too? Radium rifles that are automatic. That's gonna be sick. Interesting. The one that fell through the world is apparently not fallen through the world, or did long ago. Alright, this is just dirty. Let's just get this guy off the bridge. Put him somewhere a little bit less Yeah, that's fine. Apparently the dog is too heavy, however. Oh yeah, don't forget that somebody was trying to mail fragmentation grenades. Very useful in this early game. You know how I told Dogmeat to stay for a second so I could give him stuff? Is he still staying? Is he all the way back there? Alright, well if he's gonna be doing that, let's get a full night's sleep. And we'll check for Dogmeat in the morning. So I woke in the morning and did not find Dogmeat anywhere. Which makes me think that, yep, if you tell that dog to stay,
hey, come on.
He will fucking stay. Well, I guess we're not going to give everybody their food yet. They're just going to have to wait. Dogmeat, you get to hold on to the food longer. We're going to drop a save here, and dudes, there we go. Welcome to our new character, our new playthrough. Little different. We will see how the... Oh, kick the camera. We'll see how the machinima... like intro comms. I'll be working on that now to get it ready, just because it'll be fun to play and show you guys. And so remember our character, she's sarcastic, can be evil, will likely go for the railroad because, well, screw the foundation, screw the man, take him out, we don't like him. No more brotherhood, no more institute, screw the child of Adam. Some place like Far Harbor is chill, everybody's relaxed, nobody's doing any like real leadership. Minutemen, same thing. Railroads kind of has a structure, but it's more of like a free-spirited structure. And finally, of course, we have Synth on the Hill. Synth on the Mountain? Yeah, whatever, Arcadia. Another little bit sort of a recluse to chill. So that'll be a good start for our character prior to turning all evil with Nuka World. So anyway, dudes, thank you so much for watching. It was a total joy to have you here. If you liked what you saw, please leave a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. And of course, may the ground rise to meet your feet, the wind always be at your back, and the sun shine warmly on your sexy, sexy face. Dudes, see you later. Bye.